welcome to Luxe Life. I'm your host, Candice Bar, and we are in studio, Luxe Media Studios on Rodeo Drive. We love being in studio. Studio is fabulous. It's beautiful. The energy is great here. But who do I have with me today, Miss Maria?
Yes.
How's it going?
It's going. Thank you so much for having us again.
Of course.
Super excited to be here.
So you were on Raina's show, actually.
Yes.
And I found you on that show because I have to look at all the shows to approve them.
Yes.
And I was like, who is this lady? I have to meet her. So, but before we get into it, I have to say thank you so much again for my beautiful, look at these flowers.
You're very welcome.
Gorgeous, gorgeous flowers. They're for my birthday. My birthday's coming up. So sweet of you to bring that in and remember. So
absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Happy early birthday, and we wish you all the best.
Thank you very much. And there, I want to talk on this for a second. There is a florist that you work with.
Yes, LA Floral Boutique in North Hollywood, who is the one who designed this beautiful arrangement, Pablo.
Okay.
And he just does amazing work. So
this
yes.
is gorgeous. Like, I love butterflies. So like it's, I love this. So thank you. I love flowers.
My pleasure.
I love gifts. So.
Yeah, gifts. I mean, who doesn't, right?
If you all get to my heart, you give me gifts.
There you go. Then I know what to bring now. Every week I'll be rolling in with something. Yes.
So, you know, you and I met.
Yes.
And, you know, I'm like, you need to have your own show. And she actually just recorded her first show, which she did fabulous. Let's just say
thank
that.
You. Thank you. Thank
She's
you.
She's natural.
Thank you.
And then we're doing some PR for you because
yes.
you are expanding your company. You're growing.
Yes.
And now is the time to shine.
Yes. And I just want to say thank you for the opportunity and for really reaching out and seeing something that maybe sometimes we forget to see.
Yeah.
Because we're always in the work and doing, you know, the front line. It's hard, but thank you so much for giving us the opportunity.
Absolutely.
And for giving us a hand and taking us to the next level.
Absolutely. So you have an events company.
Yes, yes,
and
yes.
You've had it for some time.
Yes, for about 8 years. This October, we'll be celebrating our 8th anniversary.
Okay. And so I kind of want to know, you know, the whole show is always, we either interview celebrities, entrepreneurs. You know, everyone's story and journey is always interesting.
Yes.
You'll never hear the same story twice.
No. It's just like there's only one Candice Bar, right?
Yeah, so, that's right. Thank God.
Thank God. I say that about myself, too. I'm like, thank God there's only one Maria.
It's a wild ride.
Yes.
You know, you were chosen to do what you do because, you know, God knew that you could do it. So...
Yes.
You can handle it.
I always like to think that that's exactly why I'm doing what I'm doing, because God did give me this creativity and it comes naturally.
Mm.
And I could be doing this in my sleep.
Mm.
And now that I'm talking on sleep, it's like whenever we have an event, which is almost every weekend, it's like I can't sleep. Because of the excitement, like let's just say midway through the week, because I'm already envisioning all the elements coming together.
Mm.
And I'm just like, I just can't wait. And I'm like that planner that's texting my clients, like, I just can't wait. And sending them like little sneak peeks, like, look at what we have, you know, just getting hyped up leading to the main event.
Mm.
So yes, that's when I know I'm like, no, Maria, this is, you could be doing a lot of other things. And I never like to just say no to new opportunities, but I know that this is exactly what I need
yes.
to be doing.
Yes. Like
yes.
this is your soul's purpose.
Exactly.
Because, you know, again, like you're saying, like, you know, when you're in it and you're creating it and you're doing the thing of it, you kind of miss like the bigger picture of like what you're able to do for other people.
Yes.
You're giving them an experience, a really beautiful experience.
Yes.
Like it's a lot of detail what you do.
Yes.
It's a lot of organization, but when it all comes together beautifully, it's like you created that.
Yes. And I always say I created it. I designed it, but I never like to take all the credit because mm-hmm. I do have an amazing team behind me that actually helps me bring that vision to life with pulling in like beautiful arrangements mm-hmm. like this, you know, amazing organic balloon designs, just every little detail, even just to what's going to be placed on, you know, the center of your plate, all of those things. And everyone comes together mm-hmm. for Maria and Delish Event. So again, I would not be here if it wasn't for the amazing group of professionals that we work with.
Mm-hmm.
So yes.
I mean, you're the visionary, but you know, you can get nowhere really by yourself.
No. Yeah. Absolutely.
You do need to have a strong team, because having a strong team and people who get it and people who also catch the vision and are willing to be on board, it's incredibly important.
Yes, exactly. And there's instances where we'll have clients that say, I've even had it where I get the call, Maria, I have something in 3 hours. What can you put together? And I'm like, wait a minute. So I'm like, are you flexible? Because I can't get the custom print right now, but if you give me a minute, let me see it and I'll show up, you know, because those are the type of challenges that we sign up for.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm always saying, like, do you want it? And then, of course, there are those times that as much as I want to take on the project, I can't because I'm already physically committed to something else. Mm. So then there will be those times where I just can't. But if you call me and 3 hours short notice, I'm going to show up with whatever I can, and I'm still going to create something for you.
That's I love that point, too. It's like, you got every single time, you got to show up.
Yes.
You got to
show up. One way or another.
If you can, you got to show up. Yes. Because, you know, this may not hit, that may not hit, that may not hit. You got to keep going, keep going, keep going, and something's going to hit.
Exactly. And just touching back on how you're going to be helping us with our PR, and when you asked me, like, who does that for you? And then I'm raising my hand like me, but I really don't, because that's not what I do.
Yeah.
But you'd be surprised. I mean, we are still in business because everyone has been a referral.
Mm-hmm.
It's word of mouth. Mm-hmm. And because I do take my job serious, and every single vendor that we work with also has to have a certain standard of professionalism that has to be up to par with us.
Right.
Because we're all a team. Even if someone messes up, I take blame for it. I don't like to point fingers, you know? So I always say, like, you have to be the one to decide
right.
how far you're going to be able to take this. And if your clients are important to you, how you take care of them.
Absolutely.
So that, I think I've been blessed to be able to still be here and in business. And like I said, I mean, I haven't talked to you about it, but with Raina, we talked about COVID and all of that, but that's just been the word of mouth. Mm-hmm. Hey, listen, I was, you know, talking to so-and-so. They said, I needed to give you a call. You're the person for the job.
Mm.
Those are the things that I'm just like, no, I'm going to keep fighting for my dream.
Absolutely. So, yes. Absolutely. And you know, you make a way, you find a way.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Door closes, go through the window.
Yeah, or start building it, damn it.
Or kick down the wall. I don't know. Just get in there.
I'm all like, who needs a window shit? Just go.
And it's funny because you and I were at an event recently, and you know, pretty good event, you know, and because of the business that you're in, because the business that I'm in, it's like levels of expectation.
Yes, definitely.
And you know, there's definitely a difference between not having a great event planner and deciding to go cheap and do it yourself. It's a big difference.
And it shows.
And people do notice.
And it shows. People absolutely. Know. Exactly. And I always say the sole purpose for someone to have an event is to impress your guests, because you are the one who wants to create that experience for them to leave thinking, wow, what an amazing event. So next time you do post something, they're like, I don't want to miss. I'll drop what I'm doing because I know that I'm just going to have an amazing time and I'm going to meet amazing people, especially, you know, if it's like a networking event and things like that.
Right.
So people do remember even also, just like how you're greeted.
Absolutely. You know, and the location, it's like there are levels of expectation.
Yes.
Here. And even if some people don't have levels of expectation, you really should.
Yes, absolutely.
Because there is a standard of living here, and we're, you know.
Yeah, I mean, you're in Rodeo Drive. I mean,
right.
The entire world knows this, you know, street.
Right.
It's like, you say Rodeo Drive, you're doing. Exactly. It's like you say Rodeo Drive, you just think, you know, big bucks.
Yes.
That's what you think. Like,
yes.
I don't care where you're from.
Yes.
But, yeah.
It's not known for discount shopping.
That's not.
It's actually what I think it still is the most expensive street in the world.
Yeah.
As far as I know.
Probably.
So, yeah. So anyway, so there is, that's why you would hire someone in your field. preferably you.
There you go. Yeah. So make sure to call us.
But I want to talk about business because, you know, you're a mom.
Yes.
You're a wife.
Yes.
You're a business owner.
Yes.
You're busy.
Yes. Very.
You know, work is busy. Work
very,
is, you know,
yes.
going. And
yeah.
so how do you, I do not believe in the word balance because
I don't think
it's real.
I was just going to say that.
Mm-hmm. I would say function.
That is a great question because at times I don't even know how I function.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to talk about like some of the pros about, you know, being the business owner. It doesn't matter what industry you're in. I mean, you kind of get to build around it and you make it work for you. So if you have something going on in your personal life and you feel like, you know, I'm not going to be able to take that event next week, and if it's a short notice, then you just say, you know, I'm not available. But it is definitely time consuming. There is no balance. And most, like lately, the last couple of weeks, believe it or not, I've been asking myself, like, how do you find that balance? No, Maria, there is no balance.
It's not real.
There is no balance because my job per se, even though I'm busy all day, but I really, like I tell, and I thank all of our clients because they're very patient with me and they understand. And I'm like, I really don't start my work day till like 7 p.m. Because by that time, you know, everyone's fed, everyone's getting ready to go to sleep. And then mom stays up until midnight because now I have to get back to whoever we have. We need to order this. We need to order that. And the nice thing about the community and being connected with our, you know, vendors on social media is that they're answering me at 11 o'clock at night. Exactly. Because they're working as well. So yes, there is no balance in my life. I don't know that, you know, I'm ever going to find it because things are only going to get busier for us. And that's what we hope for. But there are days that I'll just disconnect and I'll take just a break and I'm not available today.
Right.
And that's what we do. We'll hang out with the kids or just even if we're just hanging out at home, I'm just not available.
Right.
But that's just
You do have to kind of set that up for yourself because if you don't do that, then it's never going to happen.
Exactly. Yes. And I think that's we're very fortunate now that we are in a place where we can decide and we can now decide who we want to work with. Now, before, we would take everything and anything because, again, and I'm grateful for that, for the experience, because otherwise I wouldn't be here today.
Right.
But now we've already set ourselves up where, you know, we have our regulars and we already know, you know, who we're going to work with and what's coming up. And then we'll decide. But not only that, but I do take like little side projects on the side too. I do have some interior design background. So I'll take on little side projects as such. So yeah.
Very nice. Yeah. Yeah. So that's, you know, that's a true entrepreneur. You kind of just, again, make a way, find a way.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And so when... I know your kids, are they under the age of 4?
So, yes, they are. Okay. So, I have my little guy who just turned 1.
Okay.
And then the other little guy who is 3. And they come with me everywhere. And even today, they're downstairs in the parking lot waiting for mom. Okay. You know what I mean? So, that's what I'm talking about. Like, yesterday, we had meetings back to back. They were with me. And, of course, I'm not going to take them to, you know, a corporate meeting.
Right.
But if these are, like, backyard events that I'm planning... then they'll come.
Yeah.
But, and if that's not the case, well, then I'll have, you know, someone watching them for me on the road as we go.
Smart.
So, yeah. So, yeah, I make it work for me as much as I can.
You really do. You really make a way. You really find a way.
Yeah. I'm determined, believe it or not.
There is no, I can't. There's, let me figure out how to do it.
Let me figure out. And then most of the times, if I'm able to, like I told you before, I'm going to try, but then there are those times that I just can't, and I don't have, let's just say, any babysitter that I'd leave my kids with, so because they are my priority. So it needs to be, it also needs to make sense for me. Like, is it going to be worth, you know, me leaving my kids or not being able to have that one person take care of them for me in the car while mom, you know, takes care of business.
Absolutely.
So just also not losing, you know, my vision too, that they are my priority.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah. So... you know, I know you talked about the rain, but we have to talk about on the show because, you know, we went through an experience a couple of years ago. Everybody did. The entire world did.
Yes.
And with your line of work, how did you navigate through that?
So that was some pretty scary times, just like everyone else, whether you were a business owner or not. I mean, you either you lost your job and or you were about to lose your business because we were considered non-essential. So I did think I'm going to be out of a business soon. And I was talking to my husband, but my husband's always that one guy that says, we're going to be fine. Just don't worry. We're going to, because we figure it out. He's like, what we do is figure things out.
Right.
So don't worry about it. And he's kind of like that guy that brings me down and, you know, put some sense into me. So I said, okay, so if he said we're going to be fine, that means we're going to be fine. So we did take a little downtime, just like everyone else. I started doing more things around the house. I started cooking. I mean, before I was known for just cooking quesadillas, but now I could add a couple more ingredients to the dishes I was preparing. I was more hands-on and, you know, going through our inventory and all that fun stuff. But then I said, okay, that's not going to go very far, so we have to pivot. I said, what are you going to do, Maria? So I had this idea for some time now that I wanted to get an ice cream cart, but you can't really just go out and find one. It has to be like pre-ordered, and it does come from Mexico. At least from my vendor, that's where they were coming from. So she said, guess what? Your cart is here. And I was like, you gotta be kidding me. And I said, perfect. So what am I gonna do? So I said, well, we can't show up and do our full design, you know, that we'd normally do, or stay around and help. So I'm going to start offering ice cream. I'm going to start offering ice cream for these little celebrations or these little drive-by gatherings that people were having in their front porches. So I said, I'm going to fill it up with ice cream. Client can pick. We have over 100 flavors you can pick from, and have handcrafted ice cream as well. And I'm just gonna drop it off. So that's what I was doing. I was dropping it off. And then sometimes if they had a little bit more money in their budget, I would do like a nice little backdrop custom with balloons and things like that. So I was still participating in the celebrations one way or another. And then we were able to meet a lot of new clients that, you know, called us back after things got a little bit more flexible. And they were like, we want you to come back. And then that little ice cream cart kind of carried us through. And now we make it part of one of our a la carte services that we offer.
So smart. That's an entrepreneur.
And I always tell my husband, I don't care if I have to walk with my children, fill up that cart with ice cream. I will make it. I will make it. I'll be that Mexican lady walking down, but my cart.
I don't care.
But let me tell you, my cart is super cute. So at least I'll be in fashion. And my kids will help me sell the ice cream. Yeah.
That is an entrepreneur.
I got to do what you got to do.
Yeah. 1,000,000%. I love that.
Yes.
So after that, you know, after we came out of that.
Yes. So
I heard that 2021 was your best year as of yet.
Yes. As of yet. No, 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 no. And I always say as of yet because we have, you know, and with your help, we're just going to take it up a notch.
Skyrocket.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. And it was. And I was impressed because not only that, but I was also pregnant with my second child. So that was also very difficult. And it was very emotional because even though COVID still wasn't, it wasn't like at its peak, but it was still considered, you know, we still are under the pandemic, my husband was not able to kind of come with me on the journey, especially like these doctor visits and things like that. So that was very hard on me. And it was like a very emotional road that I had to kind of like navigate all by myself. It felt like it. So not only was I running a business, I was pregnant, and then I still had everything else in between. And I remember we had our son. And not to mention, he was born in our home. That was kind of like
I remember you mentioning it.
So yes. That was also, I think, like he actually did come to bless us even more. And we have just been nonstop ever since. So, I mean, I had him, and then I had my first event after having him a week later.
Wow.
Yes. So I'm not kidding. Like, that's the type of like determination that I have. I was talking to you a little bit prior to we got started with the show. My father is ill, and I remember when I received the call when we were like, okay, he's probably not going to make it. And I had two events the following day that could not suffer the consequences of me not being emotionally stable. But I pulled through.
Yeah.
We pulled through. I said, I never like to, you know, bring my personal business onto whatever I have going on with any of our events. But that was one of those situations where I feel I was actually tested. I mean, here I have my father who he's on the phone and we're like, we don't know if he's going to make it. And then I have, you know, vendors blowing up my phone because we have two separate events. Like, what are we doing? Like, blah, 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 blah. And then I'm thinking, no, like God, hold my hand.
Yeah.
And then we're just going to get through this.
Yeah.
And we got through this. Yeah. And thankfully my father, you know, is now doing a little bit better, but ooh, that was like a really close call. So I do feel I was tested whether I was going to do what I said I was going to do to for my clients, or was I just going to be like, well, I can't because, and then stay home and cry. Yeah. So
it's not going to get you anywhere.
It's not going to get me.
I call it shelving feelings. And I think I'm pretty good at it. It's like a lot of life happens. A lot of things go on, business, personal, otherwise.
Exactly.
Outside things coming
in. Exactly.
And with like you were saying, it's like, I understand what's going on. I have feelings toward it. I'm going to shelf those feelings for now. Yeah. I'm going to do the thing I need to do. And then when I'm ready to take it back down off the shelf and deal with it, I will.
Exactly. Well, that's a really good concept. Mm-hmm. I've never really thought about it, but yes, it's kind of like you just put in a little compartment in your head.
I'm not forgetting about it.
Exactly.
I'm not ignoring
it. It's there.
It.
And I was, and thankfully we have an amazing friend who's a nurse and was able to come to his rescue who helped him get out of the situation he was in. But I was at my event and I was on the phone like, what's my dad's status? What is he doing? Because she kept us, you know, in the loop. So that's the stuff that happens. Like, but yeah, I was present in my event, but I still was like, dad.
And this is a week after you had your kid.
Well, this was a couple months after. Okay. But yeah, but I was back at work a week after.
That's so wild.
Yeah. So
that's so wild.
Yeah.
It's like if you ever want to test the strength of a woman. Like,
yes.
Let's get tested.
Exactly. And then having a baby with no epidural, girl, I thought I died and came back like 100 times. Yes. That was just, so after that, I was like, yeah, I guess I could do everything and anything.
Yeah.
I was like, what
I
else?
Anything.
I could do anything.
Honestly, you can because you've done it.
Yes.
So what else do you need to
exactly.
Done?
What else? Like, yeah. Just throw it at me.
Bring it on.
Yes. Bring it on. Yeah.
So very excited about, you know, you went through so much stuff and,
yes.
You know, it never stops.
It's an ongoing.
It does not stop. If life is going, we're
going.
Yeah,
exactly. Let's go.
So we're in 2022 now.
Yes.
And, you know, you're rocking and rolling. You actually have an event coming up soon.
Yes, this weekend. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
And so what are your hopes, goals, dreams for at the end of 2022 you want to be in this position?
Interesting that you asked that question because this year I've actually made it a goal for myself to really invest in myself. So I am going to restructure the business because of, as I shared to you, kind of like the vision that I have for D-Lish events and really take it to the next level. So we kind of have to restructure everything. But most importantly for me, in order to be able to take our business to that next level, it starts with me. So I'm investing in myself. And so I am now being very selective as to what we will be taking on because I do want to use that time to sharpen my skills, to learn, you know, what's trending right now in our industry and also meet new people.
Absolutely.
And really just take it to the next level, start doing events at a different caliber and start meeting the planners that are already there. Like, how did you get to that point in your career?
Give me your secret sauce.
Exactly. And I'm not, and yeah, just give it to me. Mm-hmm. How, and like we were talking about the other day too, it's all about who you know.
1,000,000%.
It's all about who you know, who's going to take your hand and say, listen, I got this girl who can take care of you.
It's so, not even, you know, the world we live in. It's really not even how talented you are.
No.
It's really just who you know.
Listen, that's exactly how I ended up in the hospitality industry. My friend, who now still owns a couple hotels out in Orange County, I called him when I lost my job, okay, because I used to model before.
Okay.
And I said, listen, I just lost my job because of the budget cuts. Can I do anything for you? He's like, well, what do you know? What can you do? And I go, nothing. And then I go, I'll even do housekeeping if I have to. But, you know, I just need to figure it out. He goes, don't worry. One of my girls is out on medical leave in the sales department. Just come here. Start this. Your desk. Go. And that was that. I knew nothing about the industry. I knew nothing about selling. I mean, I have a degree in psychology and minor in criminal justice. So I, right there to your point, if I had not known him, who knows if I would have been here.
Right.
But he just said, here you go. I didn't even have an interview. He just said, she's working here. And this is who she is. She's a sales and catering manager. There you go. So, and that's how it started.
You know, I love the saying, run toward the fire.
Yeah.
You run toward the fire, yeah. not away from it.
Yeah.
And you just deal with it. You just do your thing, yeah. do what you need to do, just
exactly.
get it done.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
we are leveling up this year. This year is the year, I've been saying it, this year is the year of yes. This year is the year of leveling up. This yes. year is the year of no compromise.
Yes.
This year is the year of getting it done.
Yes.
Really getting it done.
Yes.
On bigger levels,
yes.
bigger
that
scales.
We could have ever imagined.
Yes.
Yes.
Dream big, go big, do the whole thing.
Yeah.
Do it.
Yes.
Anything that you want to share with everybody that they should know, because they need to know, you know, this is getting out to a lot of different places right now.
Yes.
So they need to know who you are. And I'm, you know, this is the third, your third time. Mm-hmm. This is your third time in Luxe Media Studios.
Yes. Yes.
So everyone's going to know you yes. shortly, but how can they find you? Where are you? What's your specialty? What do you like to do?
Okay. So they can definitely find us on social media. They can go to our Instagram page, Delish Event. And then all of our information, we have a link there so they can, you know, our phone number and everything. And then there's a form they can fill out. So that's how they can find us. What I personally love to do is obviously plan amazing and unforgettable events and also design them. I like to be involved in every little aspect and detail of your event. So that's what I love to do. And, you know, I hope that...
And you really do everything because, you know, I know earlier you talked about, like, you know, just during, from the ice cream cart, like really beautiful ice cream cart to
yes,
weddings.
It doesn't matter if it's a corporate event. I mean, like I said, I've had parties of two. And
wow.
That's exactly like the range that I've done.
Yeah.
I've been involved in the entertainment industry. You name it, I've probably done it. Grand openings, not only like the weddings and your quinceañeras or your, you know, social events, but other, you know, business related celebrations. For that matter.
Kids parties, everything.
Everything,
you name it.
We've done it. And if you are thinking about it and there's still not like a title for it, we'll make one up for you. But we are there just to really bring a smile to everyone's face. Like I said, the experience that you're going to walk away with is just going to be unforgettable.
Yes.
But it starts with the personal touch on everything that we do. And I'm always wanting to make sure that our clients and our customers are happy. And if they're happy, then we've completed our job. And then if they're not happy, what can I do to make it so that
right.
you are,
right.
you know? So, but we've been fortunate enough that, like I said, we have amazing clients that love us and that really want to support us.
Yeah.
That's just the bottom line.
Yeah. And
yeah.
You know, now people are ready to go out. People want to get,
yeah,
to, they're
people
dying
now
to get together.
Are like, let's party, Maria.
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
So, well, I'm excited for you.
Thank you.
You've been on quite the journey. I mean, we really didn't get through enough of it, but you'll talk about it on your show.
Oh, yeah,
now.
Yeah, absolutely.
She has a show on Luxe Media now, so you're going to have to
thank
check
you.
That out as well.
Yes.
She'll be on every week and
yes.
be talking about, you know, her things. She'll be interviewing other people, you know, whatever she wants to be doing with her show, she'll be doing that. But it's going to be interesting. It's going to be fun.
Yes.
It's definitely going to be enlightening. That's for sure.
Yes. At least we hope, right?
It
you're
will.
All like, you can't please everyone,
it
but
will.
At least
it
if
will.
There's one person that we can inspire to go out and, you know, go after the dream, then it's just made it all worth it.
So you're going to be seeing Miss Maria, you know, not only in Luxe Media Studios, but you're going to be seeing her all over. So get to know this face, get to know this lady. She's a powerhouse. She's up and coming. We're going to launch her. And this is
yes.
what we're doing. So
yes.
tell
thank
them one
you.
More time where they can find you.
You can find us on our Instagram page at Delish Events. Thank you.
And thank you for coming back to the studio.
Yes.
We'll, of course, be seeing more of you. Thank you everyone for listening
yes.
and watching Luxe Life with Candice Bar. And we will see you all again next week. Bye, everybody.
Glutathione is a big word. It's the body's own master antioxidant. It's a scavenger for free radical, bacteria, and viruses. There are no products in the market with the ingredient NASET. NASET increases the production of glutathione that's in our body already to strengthen and enhance our immune system, elevate sense of well-being, support muscle strength and endurance, cognitive function, and liver support. It helps with increased energy and blood sugar regulation. Get your bottle of GSH Plus from www.salvationnutra.com.